We've spoken about acid-base reactions earlier in the year, particularly when we talked about double replacement or double displacement reactions. We said the mixture of an acid and base would produce water, and we now know a salt. This was our Arrhenius definition of an acid-base. But reactions with acids also occurred in single replacement reactions or single displacement reactions. We saw that you could use a metal to replace the hydrogen in an acid. For example, in lab, we did things like put magnesium or zinc metal in hydrochloric acid and made observations. This was the lab where we collected the hydrogen gas and performed the pop test. So as a single replacement reaction, hopefully you remember this format, where you have a loner hanging out with a couple dancing. The loner swoops in, displaces one of the couple, and starts dancing with the other. This was the experiment we did in the lab. We took magnesium and placed it in hydrochloric acid. The magnesium came in and kicked out the hydrogen and produced pure hydrogen gas. We collected the hydrogen gas and did the pop test. So let's try another one. What happens if we put zinc in nitric acid? Well, the zinc is a metal, so it forms positive ions. It's going to want to bond with whatever has a negative ion, in this case, the nitrate. Now we have to remember that zinc as an ion forms a positive 2 charge, and nitrate has a negative 1 charge. The hydrogen is going to be left by itself. And as we saw in the previous example, hydrogen's a diatomic, so you're going to form H2. So you end up making zinc nitrate, ZnNO3 in parentheses 2, and elemental hydrogen, H2. Balance it, you're going to have to put a 2 in front of your nitric acid to give yourselves two hydrogens and two nitrates. This was an example of a single replacement reaction. Let's remember what the double replacement reactions look like. What would happen if you put aqueous calcium hydroxide and mix it with nitric acid? Calcium as an ion forms a plus 2 charge. Hydroxide is OH minus. And we just saw nitric acid. Nitric acid has an H plus and an NO3 minus. So calcium hydroxide would be CaOH2, and that's going to be aqueous. Then nitric acid would be H NO3, and that would be aqueous. So when they react, we're going to switch partners. The H and the OH are going to come together, and the Ca and the NO3 are going to come together. So H and OH come together, that makes H2O. And the calcium and the nitrate are going to come together. Now plus 2 minus 1, so that's going to be CaNO3 2. To balance this, I'm going to need two nitrates. I'm going to put a 2 here, and then that gives me two hydrogens and two hydroxides, so I'm going to put a 2 in front of the water. Our calcium nitrate, if you remember our solubility rules, will be aqueous because all compounds with nitrate are soluble with water, so this is going to be aqueous. And that's our balanced equation. This is an Arrhenius acid-base reaction because Arrhenius said that acids have H plus, bases have OH minus. When you do a double replacement, you're going to make water. And you're going to make a salt. So in this case, the salt we make is calcium nitrate.